The Philippine Justice Department confident government has a strong extradition case against expelled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. DOJ Undersecretary Raul Vasquez says the arguments of Teves and his legal team are unfounded. Teves is accusing the Philippine government of political persecution. The DOJ says his lawyers are also claiming Teves would be given the death penalty if he returns home, a punishment that is not even allowed in the Philippines.
They are saying that the human rights performance and protection in the Philippines is so bad that no one can expect, or no accused can expect, a fair and impartial trial in the Philippines, number one. Number two, that the justice system doesn't work in the Philippines. Number three, that there is a threat as to his safety. Number four, that the death penalty may be meted on him. In fact, yung sinasabi kanina ni Attorney Topacio na life imprisonment, technically walang life imprisonment na penalty sa penal laws natin. He is charged with a high crime of murder and attempted murder as a co-conspirator and the so-called mastermind. We exhort the good former congressman to face the court proceedings here.
Teves is facing multiple murder charges in the Philippines for the 2023 assassination of Negros Oriental Governor Roel de Gamo and nine others. His lawyer, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio, insists his client was released from detention in Timor-Leste this week.
The person, they call it the extraditee, is taken into custody of the extradition court to ensure that he or she appears before the court when the hearing starts. So, iba po na hindi naman aresto ito eh. Ang tawag po rito sa procedure ng extradition ay custodia legis. He was taken in the custody of the court. So, he was not taken back to prison. Whoever is not favored in the extradition hearing will have the right to appeal to a higher court. And in the meantime, if it is if the ruling is against us, the extradition is stayed until after the termination of the appeal.
The Justice Department earlier disproved Topacio's claim by publishing a photo of Teves in handcuffs as his extradition trial continues. More Chinese military uniforms are discovered as authorities continue their search at the massive Pogo hub in Porac, Pampanga. Let's get details from our correspondent, Gracie Rutao. Hi, Gracie. What can you tell us?
Stanley, on the fifth day of the search at the Lucky South 99 compound in Barangay Santa Cruz, Porac, Pampanga, authorities discovered more items. On the third floor of Building 11, four pairs of Chinese military uniforms, two pairs of combat shoes, and six safety bolts were confiscated. In Building 3, system monitors were seized, revealing almost the entirety of the facility: computers, computer parts, cell phones, SIM cards, and torture devices were also recovered. Additionally, three live CCTVs were found on the first floor of Building 36. A Chinese flag was also found in Building 15. Authorities are confident that the implementation of search warrant will be completed within 10 days as of Tuesday, with 29 out of 46 buildings already searched. And that's the latest here in Pampanga. Back to you, Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much, Gracie Rutao.